Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The show is about to begin. Before it does, two public announcements. Firstly, out of consideration for your fellow patrons, please turn off your cell phones. And secondly, if you're one of those I love Pink Floyd but I can't stand Roger's politics people, you might do well to fuck off to the bar. Thank you. Please enjoy.
You are only blank, air conditioned full time, backseat gun rack, glad I'm up there. They pick horses from courses, they're evolving forces.
We meant to change a nation, and instead, we changed a world.
You're good for
my forties, your weather right. You're old, but you still like a laugh in the locker room. You can't buy a change, you're the home on the range. You open the suitcase behind the old workings to show off the magic. You're deaf in the can, a comfort of friend, only upstairs. Does it remind you of a sex?
Oh man, what the hell are you gonna do next?
Hey, all the time, who you gonna kill next? Oh, Dr. Jordan, what did I see? Sorry, you whispered in a pile of debris. I swam in your pools, lay on your palm trees, looked in the eyes of the Indian who lay out on the federal building steps. Through the rangefinder over the hill, I saw the frontline boys popping their pills. Sick of the mess they find on that desert steep. Thank you.
closing meeting, we all got together, and all of a sudden, just for a moment, I saw that everyone was just sitting there looking at me. And then one of them broke the silence. "Tell us about the American miracle," he said.
"Bartender, over here. Two more shots and two more beers. Sir, turn up the TV sound. The war started on the ground." "Just love those lasers, guided bombs. They're really great for righting wrongs. You hit the target, win the game. From us, 3,000 miles away. 3,000 miles away. We play the game with the bravery being out of range." Buenas tardes. That's about it. No hablo, Spanish. And that makes me very sad, because Spanish is the one language that we must all learn to speak in the future. For me. So. I just need to collect myself. I'm going to sit down. I twisted my ankle a couple of days ago, so I'm in pain. So if you see me hobbling around, it's not because I'm old, it's because my fucking foot hurts, okay? Just saying. Okay. All right, calm down. I'm going to do a song in a minute called The Bar. It's a new song that I wrote during lockdown over those couple of years. Didn't take 2 years to write the song, it's one of the songs. Anyway, it is a song about gathering somewhere. It's an idea in my mind, it's in my heart, it's in my soul. And it's somewhere where I can go. If I want to have a drink, I can. That's why it's called The Bar. But it's also somewhere where I can talk to my friends and also to strangers, where we can have a conversation without fear of being locked up or sometimes even worse things. So this little piano for this evening, this becomes our little bar in the middle of the room. And I will play the piano, and a couple of times we sing a bit of this song. Okay, but this little piano here tonight extends through the whole arena, because you are my friends, and we are all here together, and we can talk to one another. Yeah. And we can express our love for one another, and even if we don't always agree about everything. Right, I won't go on one. Where's Kate? She's not here. Never mind. That was a song that we just did called The Bravery of Being Out of Range, and it's from a record I made in the early 90s called Amused to Death. And as you saw, there were pictures of most of the American presidents, certainly since Reagan, who starts it, until the present time. And if we've been paying attention, we will have noticed that they've been murdering us. Routinely, every single president since the Second World War. And it's very important that when we go to the bar, that we talk about it. because it's kind of crazy. They're still doing it, and we have to say, why don't we stop this? Let us stop this. Stop them doing this to us, right? Okay, that's... Yeah, I know some of you agree with me. Let's stop killing one another, please! Before I came out tonight to do this, I was in my dressing room. I was resting, and I looked up, and I could see a sign. And it said, Sin Salida. And I assume that means no exit, or even no way out. Well, there is a way out. And this is where it is, here in the bar, where we talk to one another instead of killing one another. Okay, I'll finish. This first little bit of the bar concerns two ladies. One of them is an American lady, well, they're both American. One is a homeless black lady who lives on the streets of some city in the United States with her chihuahua in a cardboard box. And the other one is a younger lady who is a Native American woman who finds this old lady and rescues her and brings her here to the bar so that we can all help to look after her. That's what this is. Everybody on the bar feel pain. Yeah, sure, they do. Is everybody in the bar a little mad? Yeah, both me and you. We traded in family form for snake oil, born into the carpet beggar's life. Now we're hanging on this cross with these feelings of lust. Just watching the Liberty boat sail on by. We may seem few, but Okay.
Well, thank you. Gracias. We're now going to drift back through the mists of time to an earlier age when I was playing my rock and roll in a different band.
We're heard about the summer. dove.
So you think it's a town. Heaven from hell. Blue skies from pain. Can you tell the difference from a coasting wave? The smile from the rain. Do you think you got to go? And did they get you paid? Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.